In this video, I will demonstrate how to configure prompts for different data sources using SAS Visual Analytics 8.4, but similar steps can be used for earlier versions of SAS Visual Analytics. My first example will demonstrate how to configure both report and page level prompts to filter different data sources. Two key concepts I will use to achieve this configuration are map data, and I will create a custom category to support those data mappings. My second example will demonstrate how to configure a report canvas prompt to filter multiple data sources. The key concept covered in this example will be configuring the action to filter the report objects and configuring the map data. Let's get started with the demonstration. I will be using SAS Visual Analytics 8.4 for the hands-on portion of this video. Starting in SAS Drive, let's open SAS Visual Analytics by using the side menu and select Explore and Visualize. First thing we need to do is add our two data sources. In this example, I will be using data for two sister toy companies that going forward will report to the same manager. This report will allow the manager to select for year and product line for comparison. Using the data pane, I'm going to select the Select to Add Data, and I'm going to search for Inside Toy. I'm going to click OK to add it to the report. Using the data pane again, I'm going to use the dropdown and select Add Data Source. I'm going to search for Megacorp. And click OK to add it to the report. Now we can see the report has both data sources, Inside Toy and Megacorp. Now I will quickly create two bar charts for each data source for product line and order total and revenue. Using the Objects pane, I'm going to drag two bar charts onto the report canvas. Back on the data pane, I'm going to select my Inside Toy data first. And for the roles, I will add product line, and the measure will be order total. I'm going to click to activate the second bar, switch my data to Megacorp. I'm going to again add product line, but my measure for this one will be revenue. I'm going to update the titles of each bar chart so it's clear which data source is feeding the objects. The first prompt we want to add is the report level prompt, prompting for year. Here we can see that Megacorp has 3 years worth of data. For Inside Toy, here we can see that there are over 8,000 unique transaction dates, but we do not have a year data item. Let's go ahead and create one. The easiest way to do that is to duplicate transaction date, select a different format, in this case we want it to be year, and rename the data item. Now we can see we have 34 years worth of data for Inside Toy. Let's go ahead and configure our report level prompt for year now. From the Reports Overflow menu, use the dropdown and select Expand Report Controls. From the Objects pane, we are going to add a drop-down list to select our desired control object. In this case, it'll be a drop-down list. You could scroll down till you find your controls, or you can use the filter here at the top. I'm going to drag my drop-down list to the report prompt area. Now we need to assign the roles. Since Inside Toy is the data source with the most years, I will use this data to feed this control object. From the data pane, I want to make sure my inside toy is the active data source. And then on the roles tab for the drop-down list, I'm going to select that new year data item we created. Since I usually like to see the largest value at the top, I'm going to right-click and sort by descending. Now when I select a year, I notice that only the inside toy bar chart is being updated. Now we need to configure the prompt to also filter for the data source Megacorp. The key element that I mentioned for this first example is we will learn to map data. We're going to right-click on the drop-down and select Edit Data Source Mappings. Initially, we don't see anything mapped. This is because we need to enable our data source mapping. In this case, we want Inside Toys Transaction Year to map to Megacorp's Date by Year. And now we'll click OK. Right now, we see that Megacorp bar chart doesn't have any data for 2012. This is most likely because this data source didn't have any data for that year. If I select a different year, we can see that both Inside Toy is filtered and now Megacorp is filtered. Now we have completed configuring the report level prompt. Now we want to add and configure a page level prompt. Looking at these product lines, we can see that Inside Toy has several more product lines than Megacorp. We can see that Game is matching for both of the sister companies. Since I'm familiar with the data, I know that the other three, Promotional, Action Figure, and Stuffed Animal, do have matches in the Inside Toy. Promotional maps to Promo, Action Figure maps to Figure, and Stuffed Animal maps to Plush. We can use custom categories to create a better mapped data assignment. This is the second key concept I mentioned that we will be using for this first example. With Inside Toy active, we are going to create a new custom category. You can use the New Data Item menu and select New Custom Category, or you can right-click on the data item directly. In this case, we want to create a custom category for product line. So I'm going to right-click on product line and say New Custom Category. I'm going to give my custom category a meaningful name. Now for most of the values of product line, we are going to leave them as they are. So for any remaining values, we're going to leave show as is. We only need to rename those three where they're not identical values. So over in value group one, we're going to rename this to promotional. And we're going to drag the value promo to now be referenced as promotional. Click on the plus button to add another value group. We're going to rename this to be action figure. And we're going to drag the matching figure over to that value. Again, click the plus data item. We're going to rename this to stuffed animal. And drag over the plush. Now, for Inside Toy, on product line custom, we have matching values that will map to the Megacorp data. Let's go ahead and click OK. Now we need to add our page level prompt. We can expand the page level prompt area by using the overflow for the page and click Expand Page Controls. I'm going to show you a different way that you can add a control item to this page prompt area. This is called the Auto Control feature. Usually you select the control object and drag it to the desired prompt area, either to the report or page area. But these areas are special that if you drag a data item directly, it will automatically create a control for you. Since we want Megacorp to drive the selection of the available product lines, I'm going to switch my data to Megacorp. And I'm going to drag product line over into the page prompt area without a control so you can see what that looks like. Click on product line and drag it over. The type of control object is determined by the cardinality of the data item. The rules are listed in the SAS documentation. I'm happy with the button bar, but if you wanted to change it, you could change the type of control by using the objects overflow menu and the change to option. Now when I select a value from the button bar, action figure in this example, we can see that only the Megacorp bar chart is being filtered. We must, like before, map our data. You could, like before, right-click on this and select Edit Data Source Mappings, but I want to show you a different way. From the Data pane, we are going to use the Data menu and select Map Data Sources. Here we can see we already have the transaction year for Inside Toy mapped to Megacorp State by Year. Let's click the plus button and add another mapping. Inside Toy, we want to use our new custom category product line and map it to Megacorp's product line. We'll click OK. Now we can see that the Inside Toy bar chart updated. Notice the original data value for Inside Toy is still being displayed. So we haven't changed the underlying data since the data mapping is being driven by the custom category. One last style option I often like to change for button bars is the selected background color and text color. So I'm going to click on the button bar to activate the object and go over to my options. For the background selection color, I'm going to select teal, and the selected text color, I will pick white. Now when I click on promotional, we can see that it filters for both Inside Toy and Megacorp. And when I deselect the buttons, I have all of the product lines available to me. In my second example, I'm going to use a report that's already been started. As we can see from the data pane, I have three data sources in this report. Each data source is feeding one of the three list tables in the report canvas. I want to add a report canvas prompt so the report user can compare years in the different list tables. Like in the first example, I will need to select a data source to feed the control object. In this case, I want to select the data source with the most years. Let's click through the different available data sources to see which has the most data. For the first one, I can see that for the hockey data source, there are 92 years available. For the football data source, I have 52 years available. And for my baseball data source, I have 116 years available. Therefore, I'm going to use the World Series Champions to feed my control object. From the Objects pane, I'm going to select a list control object. I'm going to drag and drop that onto the report canvas, not into the report or page prompt area. From the data pane, I'm going to make sure that my World Series Champion data source is active, and then I'm going to drag the MLB year to the list control. Again, I like to sort so my most recent dates are up at the top. And if I select some dates, I can see that nothing is filtering any of the list tables. This is because I need to configure the filter action. This is one of the key concepts I said we were going to learn about in the second example. Still with the list control active, I'm going to select the Actions pane, and here I have my available object lists. We can see all three list tables available. I'm going to, yes, click all three list tables as a filter target. We could see the error message tells me I must map my data. I could click here and map my data, or like before, I can use the data source menu option and select map data. This will give me all of the combinations for my data sources. First, I'm going to check enable data source mapping. Right now, I do not need any other mappings beyond the year mapping, so I'm going to go ahead and delete the mappings I don't need right now. And for the World Series, I'm going to select my year and map it to the football year. Same thing for down below, the World Series. So we have our baseball to our hockey. I'm only interested in mapping the years right now. And I'm going to click OK. We can now see that all three list tables update accordingly. If I was interested a variety of different years, I can look and see, and those list tables will be filtered accordingly. For more information, please refer to the SAS Visual Analytics documentation or check out one of my other videos or blogs. Thank you, and check back with the Technical Insights and Expertise series for additional tips.